Hello, welcome again. This is question number 95 from Engineering Services, May 2020. The non-zero stress component at a critical point in the hub of a flywheel where yield is initiated are sigma xx 100 MPa, sigma yy minus 50 MPa, tau xy 50 MPa. The flywheel has a yield strength of sy is equal to 300 MPa. Determine the principal stresses and maximum shear stress. Also show them on Mohr circle of stress. To compare the vector safety with Tresca's maximum shear stress theory and Mohr machine theory. So here it is given that sigma xx is 100 MPa. And sigma yy is minus 20 MPa. And tau xy, suppose here it is acting clockwise, is 50 MPa and complementary shear stress is anticlockwise, that is 50 MPa. So if we draw these stresses on Mohr circle, so first of all we draw this sigma xx 100 MPa and this anticlockwise shear stress 50 MPa. So this is your sigma xx 100 MPa. So starting from this, this is your starting point, this is 100 MPa and this is your 50 MPa. Okay. So this is sigma xx 100 MPa and this is 50 MPa. And then we draw second stress, second stress on second plane, that is sigma yy minus 20 MPa. Tau xy 50 MPa. Okay. So this is your sigma xx minus 20 MPa. This is clockwise means upward here and here. Anticlockwise shear stress was acting here. Anticlockwise this and this make anticlockwise on this plane. If on the plane of sigma xx, the anticlockwise shear stress is acting. That's why it is in downward direction, and on the plane of sigma yy, clockwise shear stress is acting, so that's why it is in upward direction. These are the signs of nature. So this is your sigma xx, this is tau xy, this is sigma yy, this is tau yx. Okay. So now we have these two points, this point and this point. Join this point and take this acceptor and draw a circle, which is your Mohr. So here this represents the maximum shear stress and this sigma 2 is minus 45 MPa starting from this point, origin point, and sigma 1 is 125 MPa. Okay, maximum principal stress is 125 MPa, minimum is minus 45 MPa and tau max is 85 MPa. Now using Tresca theory, we have maximum shear stress at 85 MPa, and given that the yield stress is 300 MPa. Yield stress is 300 MPa. So this is yield stress in tension, and yield stress in shear according to maximum Tresca theory will be 300 by 2, that is 150. So yield stress in shear is 150, and maximum shear stress from the Mohr circle we have obtained is 85. So vector safety, this is your 300 by 2 is your shear yield stress, and 85 is your shear stress acting in the system. So vector safety is your 1.764. And according to Mohr machine theory, this is the criteria. And here sigma 1 minus sigma 2 square plus sigma 2 minus sigma 3 square plus sigma 3 minus sigma 1 square divided by the usual shear strain energy stored in the material, and the maximum shear strain energy that can be stored in the material when yield stress is applied. So if you put sigma 1 as sigma yield and sigma 2 as sigma 3 as 0, then we get sigma yield. And if we take vector safety also, or put sigma 1 as sigma yield by FOS, then we get this. And to put sigma 2 and sigma 3 as 0, then it will be like this. So now sigma 1 is sigma 1 and minus sigma 2 is 125 plus 45, and this is your sigma 2 is minus 45 square, and sigma 1 is 144, 125 square, taking this here. So we get effect of Zapier 1.006. And according to maximum principle state theory, the maximum principle state is 125 MPa, and effect of Zapier maximum yield state is given as 300, so effect of Zapier 300 by 125 value 2.2. So these are the factors of safety according to Chaska theory and Bonin theory, and according to maximum principle state theory.